Excuse me, Theo. I just did my own SBC. Pretty cool, eh?
Sir, you do realize we have two versions of Ansu Fati. We've got a tradable Eden Hazard for 50k, and Ousmane Dembele 5-star 5-star goes for about 32k on the Xbox. You do know that, right? Yes, but can Eden Hazard do this?
Día después, un jugador de España contra un jugador de Belgique contra un otro jugador de España.
Damn, that was actually pretty good.
Good evening, everyone.
What's happening, boys, and welcome to an interruption of the Road to the Final Champions League content. Yes, we are looking at the Spanish player, the Spanish La Liga, second player of the month, and it is none other than Mikel Oyarzabal for Real Sociedad, a player that was very well and fully deserving of getting this card, to the dismay of many FIFA 21 players and user base, because we already have the Hazard who goes for about 50, 60k, about the price of this SBC, tradable, and is a pretty crack card, and then we also have a couple versions of Ansu Amefati. We have the inform, and then we also have the 86. So he had himself that first La Liga player of the month. So a lot of people saw this card and they were like, yeah, three star. There's a few things that are a little bit concerning, but if you give the card a chance, and I've not done it yet, but I've looked at some Reddit comments, some Footbin and Foothead comments, I think there's a place for this card. Maybe not in your club, but there's a place in your mind to possibly consider doing this card. And today we're going to look at it. There are some stats that are absolutely ridiculous. And as a wise man once said, we're just going to jump right into it. Smash like if you guys are mad lads. Smash like if you want good pack luck in your rewards next week. And if you guys are new to the channel, hit that subscribe button down below. But yeah, Mikel Oyarzabal, he currently has, I believe, 77 more total in-game stats than the 88 rated Hazard, who they obviously have the same rating. And the first thing that we have to talk about is the fact that he's got the 3-star skill moves, 3-star weak foot. He comes in around 50-60k. The only thing you get back is the player. It's only one brick slot. It's only one portion of an SBC. High, medium, left footed. And then we get into the stats, and we start seeing a pattern forming here. 85 acceleration, 86 sprint speed, 89 attack positioning, 90 finishing with 86 shot power, 87 long shots. Dribbling stats for days, 85 agility, 84 balance, 86 reactions, 89 ball control with 90 dribbling. Those stats with the dead eye go up over 90 for reactions, goes up to 99 ball control, 99 dribbling, 97 long shots, and then 91 shot power with 99 finishing. So I gotta say, for a centrally located card, if you try him out at CAM, and I think that's probably where he's best suited, I'm not sure he's a really good out-and-out winger, even though he's got really, really good crossing in 89, 87 stamina, he's not gonna be chugging. But here's the difference maker. The outside-the-foot shot. While he may only have 3-star weak foot, this outside-the-foot shot is a big, big deal. And today, we are going to try and bring back long shots and see if the Deadeye chem style is gonna maybe help us out there. We're also gonna try something else. We're also going to try something new. We've got this Boyan, who was the MLS Squad Foundation's objective player. We're going to be running a brand new formation. Again, another thing that I picked up from Reddit, the 3-5-2, pressure on heavy touch, defensive width 5, depth 3, fast buildup, and almost maximum width on my attack. And we're going to be running Oyarzabal as a cam in this formation. Klosterman RCB, Koulibaly center back, Nico Schultz LCB, and then Gomez Cuadrado out wide. We're going to have Nainggolan as our left center mid, and then Boyan as our right center mid, and then Inaki Williams and Luis Muriel up top. So I have get in behind, stay forward on the two of them. I have stay on the edge of the box for cross, and then stay forward on Oyarzabal because we're going to be trying to rip some long shots. And then Cuadrado and Gomez are going to be our two technically wingers, and I have them on comeback on defense. But match number one with a Oyarzabal, I know a lot of, you know, there's some of you, the moment we saw this SBC, it's like, why? Like, you know, why would we do this if Hazard's tradable at 50, 60K? Again, the shooting stats are significantly, significantly better than Hazard. He doesn't have the top-end pace of an Eden Hazard, but his shooting stats and his passing stats, the only disappointing thing is that he's a left mid. I shudder to think what his price would be if he was, if he shipped as a position change, CAM or CM, but yeah, it's literally the only issue is the fact that he ships as a left mid, because there's just so many conflicts with there between the two Ansu Fatis and the Hazard. But let's get into match from one. Let's see if Luis Muriel still has a little bit of that magic from yesterday. But more importantly, let's see if this Oyarzabal can get it done as a cam.
He
yards ball. I'm sorry, my man. You're just gonna pop in a cheeky finesse right that? You're gonna pop a cheeky finesse in the top left-hand corner of the net to kick things off in the 13th minute from outside the box? Okay, yards ball. We see you, bro.
Si apre cammino sin problema. Iñaki Williams.
¿Qué haces, imbécil?
Nada, es increíble, tío.
Can someone explain to me how my PlayStation just told me I haven't touched my PlayStation? Can someone tell me how it just said my LAN cable was disconnected? I need the PlayStation Xbox. I need the PlayStation X, whatever the hell this thing is called, like stat. I think my PlayStation is falling apart. That literally just cost me a game. My PlayStation just cost me a game, bro. Are you trying to sabotage me? Are you upset that I've done this a yards ball? Are you an Eden Hazard or a Player of the Month Ansu Fati owner? What is going on? Before we were so rudely interrupted, MadLad Stadium. I mean, literally it was, what was it, 20 minutes? 20 minutes into the game. He's a body fainting mad lad. He can do that exit. Boys, what was that? Okay, no. Yo, hold on a second. Okay. Mikel Oyarzabal. 5 minutes, 16 minutes, 16 in-game minutes into the first match. And then 5 minutes into match number two. And he's going ahead and he's ripping finesses and distance bangers. What is this, FIFA 16? Is that Oyarzabal at the point? You guys know that I absolutely hate AI blocks, but unpopular opinion, if AI blocks were a thing, don't you think we'd have too many goals scored? Don't you think there'd be like way too many goals scored in FIFA?
Nada, es increíble, tío.
Anaki, bro. My dude. That's possibly the game winner. What the hell is that? Oof. Clusty. Telling you, man, this isn't the road to the final. This is not the road to the final, Clusterman. You don't need the road to the final. Stick with the 80. He's already icon level. Bro, a yards ball's a bit of a myth, man. He's playing, again, it's like I alluded to the other day when I told you guys that when I try a particular card out, I take a look at the stats, and I've played enough, I've been doing this long enough that you can look at a set of stats and you can kind of visualize what he might be in game. And the three-star isn't the kiss of death. Let's keep him in the game. Look at that. We got a body in front of the shot, and even then, Manuel Neuer, I'm not taking the chance.
What an absolute legend.
Nada, es increíble, tío.
Rashford.
Ahí se viene el disparo. What a save, Manuel Neuer. Controla la pelota, lo di.
Y así le pega la. Nada, es increíble, tío.
Gotta stop saying that.
Sigue con la pelota.
Y se metió por ahí.
There we go! Oyarzabal! Inside the box, Mikel Oyarzabal. Let's go, boys. Mikel freaking Oyarzabal with the ball roll and then the cheeky little finish. He's got the 8. He's got 99 finishing. 99 finishing with the Deadeye Chem style. Ay, yo mio, Mikel Oyarzabal. Going in, doing body feints left, right, and center. And you want to know what? We're just going to get cheeky with it. We're going to Pirlissimo him. The Pirlo Panenka. Mikel Oyarzabal, brother. Oh my dear God, and you have to end it with a dead fish. 81st minute, 4-2. Showcase the dribbling, showcase the distance bangers, showcase the chance creation, and for 50 to 60K, which, let's keep it a stack, most of us can probably get done for free. That's the difference between Hazard and this one. Obviously, it's a, you know, it's an opportunity cost evaluation, right? Would you submit 20K of tradables and then, you know, 30K of untradables? As opposed to spending that 20K tradables towards an Eden Hazard? Or do you want to possibly get this one for, in theory, free, depending on how you value your untradables? I take my untradable Division Rivals rewards every week. So for me, I factor that into the price of selecting that specific set of rewards. It allows me to unlock cards that I want for how I feel, or at least how I construe them as free. I'm gonna do something that might upset a few people. They're gonna be like, but Zwei, you can get Hazard for 50, 60K. You can still do the Player of the Month, Ansu Fati. I believe you actually have a day left to do that one. I'm gonna go so far as to say, 4 out of 5 in terms of value, 50 to 55K for a card with these stats, where if you play him centrally, you have to tinker the squad around a little bit, you gotta get creative. But if you have the Inaki Williams, if you have the Oyarzabal, and then if you have the Boyan, or if any other Spanish center mid comes out, like that Isco did today, which I don't think a whole lot of people are excited about, it's very easy to get done. So I'm gonna say 4 to 5 in terms of value, and in terms of on-the-pitch performance, I usually wouldn't do this for a 3-star, 3-star player, but I am also gonna hit him with the 4-star, 4-star on the Infinity Gauntlet, and I'm going to give him a review of a thumbs up on the Infinity Gauntlet, because he was just that impressive to me. If you want him as a winger, probably engine chem style is probably what you're gonna want on the card, but a perfect 10 rating, 4 goals, 23 out of 31 dribbles completed, didn't do any crosses, obviously, 7 out of 9 shots on target, and just an absolute hero. And again, I think we're going to focus on that first goal. Was it the first one? I mean, look at this thing, dude. This is the, he doesn't have 4-star skill moves, but the way that he does this, the way that he dribbles would make you think so. So he's able to do the ball roll to that exit really, really nicely. This, I don't even know what the skill move is. I think this was just regular, this was just me trying to get by him. He gets right by whoever that is, Klosterman, one of the best center backs in the game, and then he just goes ahead and he decides to bang it with minimum curve. Jeez! We'll be streaming late on Twitch tonight because of that, but hopefully, like I said, you guys have enjoyed the episode, and a lot of you guys in the Twitch stream yesterday, in the comments on Twitter and here on YouTube, have said, Zwei, we want that Oyarzabal, you know, let us know how he plays for you. And then I looked at the card and I was like, damn, these stats are pretty yanged out, and lo and behold, he lived up to the expectations. So like I said, thumbs up on the Infinity Gauntlet. If you guys did enjoy the episode, smash like. If you guys are new to the channel, hit that subscribe button down below. I'll catch you guys for another upload tomorrow. Hopefully we get a fun road to the final SBC. If not, we'll probably do Fonzie Davies or Zakaria Epi. And I will catch you guys for that episode tomorrow. Catch you guys for a stream later tonight. Till next time, my bros. Tschüss. Later. Ade.